So in this video, we are going to see about the infraspinatus muscle. This is the blue color part is the infraspinatus muscle, which has its origin from the infraspinous fossa. This is the spine of scapula, and above this fossa is called a supraspinous fossa, where the supraspinatus gets originated. Below this supraspinous process, there is infraspinous fossa, where the infraspinatus muscle is getting originated. Now we'll go deep into this muscle. Infraspinatus is a muscle of the shoulder girdle, of one of the rotator cuff muscles. It's a thick triangular muscle, as you can see, it is a triangular muscle here, along with other muscles of the rotator cuff, which contributing in the stabilization of the glenohumeral joint in a proper motion of upper limb. It also inserts in the greater tubercle of humerus. Origin is supraspinous fossa and insertion at the greater tubercle of humerus. Action, it is laterally rotating the shoulder joint. And its blood supply is suprascapular artery. We'll go further deep here. So, infraspinous fossa to the greater tubercle of humerus. Now the blood supply is supplied by the suprascapular vessel along with the circumflex scapular artery. Then this is the nerve supply, suprascapular nerve, which is C4, C5 and C6. Now we will see the action. Shoulder horizontal abduction along with the pec major and deltoid muscles. Then we will see the lateral rotation along with the deltoid, trapezius and deltoid and trapezius, yeah. Then shoulder adduction. Shoulder adduction is along with pectoralis major, triceps, infraspinatus, teres minor and latissimus dorsi. Thank you.